Breakfast Television is brought to you in part by Tim Hortons. This holiday season, believe in the kindness that lives in us all. Happy holidays from Tim's.
Breaking news, the sun is out in Toronto.
About time.
Didn't think we'd see that this morning. Tracy, Melissa, Sid here with you on BT. Couple things. Big hockey news out of our nation's capital yesterday. Okay. The Senators, who are dead last in the Eastern Conference, which means they are up on nobody in the Eastern Conference. They are the last team. They fired their head coach, DJ
Smith.
Couldn't
be worse.
Couldn't be worse. There's worse in the league, but not in the East. Okay. DJ Smith was let go after yet another disappointing year so far. Ottawa have lost four straight. Sens have missed the playoffs for four straight seasons under DJ Smith. Pierre Dorion, their GM, was fired not that long ago. And with new ownership in our nation's capital, Tracy, I was under the impression this instability was somehow going to end, but hockey fans in Ottawa kind of getting the same old here. This has been a wacky season.
Well, what do you think? What's this all about? Give us your Sid Sixero take on this situation.
Let's get comfortable.
Here we go. Settle in.
I haven't said anything.
I know, but we know. There's stuff to be said.
I have. Here I'm a fair and balanced person, but hit me with the good stuff on six, Kim. Let me tell you something,
yeah,
Ottawa. No, it's fine. I feel
right
terrible.
In.
I feel terrible.
You don't want to rub it in.
No, I don't, because this is like the Ottawa Senators in the National Hockey League, because you have a hard salary cap.
Mm-hmm.
When you make decisions early on young players, you're stuck.
Yeah.
And they have some interesting young players in Ottawa who have done nothing as a team.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely nothing. So nowadays in the NHL, when you need to make a move, because it's hard to trade these contracts.
Yeah.
Like, you fire the coach.
Yeah.
And it wasn't a shock, but I think Ottawa have major issues because their young core of players, no one knows if they're up for it.
Yeah.
They're talented individual players, but they were throwing a lot of money very soon.
Why do they do that?
It's an NHL thing to do. If you have a young player and you think you can sign him at a decent number,
yeah,
you give them like 6, 7, 8 years.
So you're just hedging. You're saying
100%.
We think that this person is going to deliver. We're going to throw everything at them, including the house.
Yep.
And then they don't deliver, and then they get stuck in a situation, and they fire the coach. This is
they
what
like
happens.
To fire people there.
Yep.
That's for sure. No job security.
100%. You just basically summed up the NHL salary cap system right now.
Gotcha.
You can't do anything. They just did it in Edmonton. They had a terrible start, but you can't move guys.
Right.
You fire the coach.
Mm.
We'll see how this works out, but the Senators are in a bit of a situation.
Okay.
The other thing from last night was what happened with the LA Lakers. Now, the NBA started something this year. It's very common in European soccer, but here in North America, they created a tournament inside of their regular season.
Okay.
They called it the in-season tournament. Every team was eligible. The Raptors were eliminated in like 8 minutes. They had no chance.
Okay.
But the Lakers, they went on to win the first ever in-season tournament. Now, the Lakers have won countless NBA titles, one of the most storied franchises in sports. Last night in LA, they raised a banner in recognition of the in-season tournament victory.
Okay.
LeBron James and company.
Oh, this is it here.
This is it. This is not an NBA title ceremony, okay?
Whoa.
This is the, look at this. This is the in-season tournament, not even sponsored yet.
Okay.
And they won it.
The very first one.
Very first one.
Good.
Each player gets $500,000.
Oh, that's better.
For LeBron, it doesn't matter. Some of the other guys, it might matter. But I went on my timeline this morning, and I could not believe the folks who were ripping the Lakers for having this extravagant of a ceremony. Trace, are they well within their rights to unveil a banner on a tournament that no one cares about?
If there is one thing that I think the Americans do right, it is bragging. They are, as I want to get an American to write my resume, my cover letter, please make all my phone calls, please speak to my agent, speak to the company. They know how to brag. It is almost a national pastime. So if you have this made-up tournament or conference and they win the conference, this is what you're going to see. You're going to see the pomp and circumstance of like a queen's coronation. And that's what we're seeing, the slow-mo reveal of have the dramatic, beautiful banner. Why not?
I wonder how much of it was the league, too, saying, hey, we want you to sell it. We want you to sell it like it's a big deal. Like, look at the sparkles on that brand new trophy. Like, they were showing it off. They want it to be a big deal. So maybe the Lakers are like, sure, we win all the time. We know how to celebrate. Here we go. Why not?
I agree with everything that's being said here. And again, the league's main issue here was, people have to take it seriously, or we're not going to sell this. There's a team that took it seriously.
Also, I didn't know that was the motivation either for this thing to get people interested earlier on in the season. That's an interesting hook.
The NBA's in a weird spot where a lot of their top players will take like 40% off of the regular season.
Why are they doing that? It's just
teams
like,
allow it. It's unbelievable. It's a great question. Okay. I don't know why. But this is an effort to kind of keep the juices flowing early.
Right.
I think it worked.
They're flowing juices.
There's a lot of flowing juices.
You see that slow-mo reveal?
Yes.
Come on!
You know, so many things
like
flowing.
Making it a spectacle. Like one NBA game is kind of like representative of the season, too, where it's those last final minutes that really count. It's the end of the season that really counts, and now here it
Look
comes.
Look at this. I'm motivated
Look
to exercise watching this. Look at this.
Sparkly lights.
Wow. I also didn't know everybody got $500,000. That's
that was a big deal for me.
I want a banner reveal for that.
So congratulations for the Lakers for taking it seriously. Good for you. I agree.
They sure did.
All right, we're going to take a break. You sound off coming up afterward. Stephen Guilbeault, our environment minister, at some point today is going to announce how he's going to get car sales in this country by 2035 to all be electric vehicles. Not all cars on the road, but just all new car sales by 2035. That's not going to be easy.
How confident
are you in purchasing an EV vehicle right now? Feedback at breakfasttelevision.ca. That discussion straight ahead.